Another element of Adam's voice, which you will have clearly heard on Underneath, for example, and which fills me with excitement, is the fact that he uses vibrato, unlike many other pop singers today. It is one of the most important elements in creating pleasing flexibility, tenderness, and richness to the tone of his voice. Without it, he will emulate the current popular singing style comprised of what we call white sounds or straight sounds, which actually often sounds more like yelling or shouting than singing. But vibrato also does something else. Apart from helping to create a wonderful tone and protecting the vocal instrument, vibrato also creates the illusion of true pitch, which makes for interesting, energetic, effervescent and vibrant sounds. Voice specialists tell us that a good singer will have an average vibrato of from 5 to 8 regular pulsations per second, and I'm willing to bet that Adam's vibrato adheres to that ideal too. Of course, he sometimes uses straight sounds too, but it's very obvious he does so as a stylistic element only, and that he consciously chooses to do so, and not because it's the only way he can sing, as it is for so many other pop and rock singers today. Listen now to how Adam sings the title track from his second album, Trespassing, brought to us by Kinky Kiedis, and you'll be able to hear what I've been talking about. Another reason I feel Adam's voice is so beautiful is because he's able to produce sound of equal quality and intensity throughout his range. This is no mean feat. It is something singers work on their entire lives. Here is a song I can't resist playing for you because it is so beautiful and demonstrates so many of the points I've raised about his voice. It's Adam's version of Stay by Rihanna, brought to us by Hermes K. This is the version he sang in Seoul, Korea, in 2013. Adam is able to really convey the emotion of the song, and if you watch the YouTube video, you'll notice that he's indeed wearing his heart on his t-shirt. And that is what the human vocal instrument does, more than any man-made instrument. It touches our emotions, our hearts and our souls, and Adam's voice seems particularly able to do so, more than any other I've experienced. I always have enormous fun at Adam's shows, and Helsinki in 2013 was no exception, despite the freezing minus 20 degrees Celsius conditions. But I wasn't the only one. Two of Adam's fans camped out for two nights in a row in the snow in front of the venue in order to get a good spot from which to watch him. So, let me introduce Rosa Marie and Alina from Finland. In a Skype chat with me, this is what they had to say.
I'm Rosa Marie, and I'm 19. I'm turning 20 this summer, and I'm working now in a grocery store.
Welcome to the sound path, Rosemary.
Thank you. And my name is Alina, and I'm 20, and I work in a fast food restaurant.
Hello, Alina. Thank you very much and welcome to the sound path.
Thank you.
So I want to ask you guys, I think Rosemary, you've seen Adam before and you were a fan of his before, but
Yes.
Alina, you were not. Am I right?
Yeah, well, I have listened to his music and I've had friends who listen to him, so I've known some stuff, but I wasn't so much into it before this concert.
Okay, so I want to find out about the fact that you guys camped outside the venue in minus 23. Am I right? 2 days before the show.
Yeah.
That's crazy. That's hardcore fandom. I was so surprised. Can you tell me why you did that?
I had that crazy idea that let's camp 2 days, more than 2 days, outside the venue, because last time when Adam was in Helsinki, I waited him for 30 hours. So, and I wasn't the first one there. So I'm
Wow.
thinking that time more, 50 sounds good. And then
Wow.
I asked if Alina would love to come with me, and it happened.
Well, I think you guys are very brave and crazy. Okay, so can you tell me what it was like to stay outside in the cold waiting for Adam and then to hear from him? Because I think he tweeted you, did he?
Actually, he tweeted all the fingers, but I don't know how did he notice that we were waiting outside.
I think a lot of Glambirds tweeted it to him.
Yeah. Yeah.
They were saying, because we came to see you and some others came as well, and they tweeted it to him that there were people camping out in the cold.
Maybe that's why he noticed.
Yes. And then did he invite you? Did you get to meet him?
Yeah, actually.
Yes. That's
Yes,
fantastic.
he
Great.
invited us to the meet and greet. Yeah, because there were some meet and greet for people who had won to get to meet him, so before the show.
Right.
So we got to go there.
That's fantastic. Congratulations.
Thank
You
you. Thank you.
must have been so excited.
Yeah, I still can't believe that it's true. It was fantastic because he said that he wanted to meet us.
Yes, that's fantastic. So what was it like? Can you tell us a little bit about what it was like to meet him face to face?
Well, I just couldn't believe that he actually was there. I was just staring at him. He looked so beautiful. He had so pretty makeup and hair and everything, and he was so nice.
And his eyes.
And actually, everyone says that he's friendly and stuff, but when you meet him in person, you really see that all the rumors, and they really are true. He really is a person with a heart what's pure cold, and yeah, and he's so warm and open, and it's really easy to be there with him. He's
Yeah, even though it was kind of exciting moment.
yeah, it was really nice.
That's fantastic. How many people were there when you got to meet him?
Actually, there were like 14 people in the meet and greet, but we all went
One by one.
one by one to the room where Adam was.
So you got some time with him. Were you able to think coherently and ask him questions?
I think at least we tried.
We tried,
But it was
yeah.
really quick though. We got the picture with him and then just
Like couple.
talk a little bit.
I'm so chuffed for you guys because
Yeah.
yes,
And he was
doesn't.
like asking that, how are we, because we were in the cold so long. And
And how did we like stand for the cold? And he hoped that we would really have a great gig and we would party a lot.
Yeah, he was really caring and he promised that this show is gonna be worth it.
And
And
it was.
yeah, it was.
It certainly was. So did you get to the front of the stage?
No.
No, we actually, when they let us in before with the VIP people, we were in the front row, but then the security guys came like, hey, you should meet Adam. Why are you here? So then we went to the meet and greet. So when the show started, we were in the middle of the crowd. But it didn't matter because we saw everything and we got to meet him, and it was just perfect.
Oh, that's fantastic. I'm so pleased for you. But it's a shame that you've queued up all those hours and you were not able to get near the stage, right? Were you disappointed?
Well, we were able to meet Adam, so...
So that made up for it.
Yeah.
You were also interviewed by all kinds of press in Finland, am I right?
Yeah.
In Helsinki because of that?
Yeah. It was weird.
Crazy. I don't know. We were so confused that Finnish media was really interested about us and about Adam.
And that's what I think is amazing, because of your actions, you helped to promote him.
Yeah, that's one reason. The promoting, that's why we camped outside, because we wanted to also promote him.
Yeah, and show that we are really
dedicated.
And we are really willing to do that for him.
We would do anything for him, so...
Oh, that's so wonderful. And I'm sure he appreciates it enormously, obviously.
Yeah, he said that.
Yeah. So you went on television.
Yeah.
And
in a couple of newspapers, radio. There was other Finbirds
that were interviewed in the radio. And
but they said...
They were looking for us.
But they said about our actions there. So also radio world knows.
Yeah, I think everybody knew that we were 2 days before the show.
Yeah.
I admire you enormously because I don't think I could do what you did. How did you survive the cold? How did you sleep there and go to the toilet and eat something? How did you survive?
Well, we have the tent and we had lots and lots of warm clothes.
Like lots. Really, really.
We actually gave some clothes to some other people because they were so cold.
And we weren't, so...
Wow. So how many people were actually queuing? I mean, camping out?
Well, one night before the show, there was like
20. But it was freezing out there, like minus 10.
Or more than that.
But on Friday, there were minus 10, so...
During the day, yeah.
Yeah, so it was really cold for everyone.
Yeah, because we had very much clothes, but they were only like they had like the little jackets and jeans, and I don't know how they
survived. We weren't worried about ourselves. Yeah. We were worried about others.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so sweet. You're amazing. You really are amazing. And yes, I think it was far colder than minus 10 because we checked the temperature and it was minus 14 during the day, and they said minus 23 at night. We were really worried about you guys.
Well, it felt like that.
It felt like at night it felt minus 20 or something.
Yeah, and I woke up a couple times because it was so cold, but it was more just like colder than I'm used to, but I have so many clothes that it was okay. But I think the other people couldn't even sleep because it was so cold.
They had to move all the time.
Yeah, walk around.
So tell me a little bit about the concert then. I think it was your very first concert, was it, Alina?
It was my first Adam's concert, yeah.
Right.
It was my fifth time to see him.
But
third concert.
Right. So what was it like? Can you tell us, Alina, especially because you've never seen him before, what was that like to see him live?
Yeah, it was really amazing because I have seen some videos on the internet, but it was so much more really see his personality and the energy live there. It was amazing, and I had my camera, but I was just some moments when I was just staring at him, and he is really there, and it's all happening, and it everything sounds so good. He has so amazing voice live, and it was a great show.
Were you surprised to hear his voice is so different live than it is on recordings?
I think maybe in some songs, yeah.
And Rosemary, you've seen him before. You said you've seen him 5 times and this was your third Adam concert.
Yeah.
Do you think this was better than the others you've seen?
Absolutely.
Why?
Maybe.
because we waited so long that it's really like we were in the right mood, and maybe it's because it was Hartwall Arena. It was huge audience and Adam really was excited to perform in Finland, and I don't know, maybe the mood there was the reason, and because I really love the Trespassing album. The songs are so great and I was excited to hear them live.
I agree. I mean, it was an amazing concert. The energy was phenomenal. It really, really was. Because I've seen him before too.
And I think because it was the last show on this tour and there were so many people waiting for it and all the expectations, and then...
Was better than we expected.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he delivered, right? He always delivers.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. Why are you fans of Adam? What is it that makes you become a fan of somebody like him?
I think first there's the music. And when you really start liking the music, you get interested at who's making the music. And now that Adam is really inspiring person and really someone to look up to.
Yeah, and when I first saw, I have been a fan of Adam since first American Idol broadcast.
Right.
So I said to my mom when I saw him first time, and he said, "I'm gonna sing Rock With You by Michael Jackson." I said, "Mom, he's gonna be so awesome. He's gonna be so big because he's gonna sing Michael Jackson." I'm a huge fan of Michael Jackson also.
Ah.
So then he sang and it was like the greatest what I have ever heard. So then I interested about him, and during the contest I really, I don't know how to say, it's really hard to find words how he affects to us because he's so unique. Maybe that's why I love him, because
he's so different from anyone else.
Yeah, and he dares to be himself, and also the music, and there's not enough words to describe why he is so great.
It's just all those things together that makes him so interesting.
He's like a puzzle.
In what way?
I mean, if you would take away his, let's say, his charisma, he wouldn't be the same. But if you have all the pieces, it's Adam. Right. And every single piece is important.
I agree with you. I find his fans very loyal and very passionate.
Yes.
And what is interesting to me is that he's created this family of fans all around the world who otherwise never would have met each other. And yes, he's very inspirational. I agree with you. So is there any message you would like to give Adam?
Well, maybe I would just like to say that I wish him everything well. I hope he gets a great career and he really is going to be himself. I hope that he's satisfied with himself because he's amazing. He shouldn't listen to any haters and stuff because we all know that he's perfect as he is.
Yeah, and he really should be proud of himself because he has created all these fans to get together, and he made everyone to believe in ourselves and to other people, and he's really doing something.
Actually, people are doing their dreams true, because when I didn't listen Adam, I didn't dare to do many kind of things, but now I'm in a musical. I never thought that I could do that. Now I'm in a musical and I dare to sing in public, and I don't know.
That's fantastic. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I agree with you. Adam does inspire us to live our dreams. I've been an opera singer all my life, but now I've gone back into the theatre and we have created a show called Tempest, and it's based on Adam's performances in the Zodiac show. And we've already performed in the West End in London, but we are creating it bigger and we're going to make a bigger musical theatre. And it's all because of Adam.
That's great.
That sounds incredible.
You have to come to London when we do it.
Yeah.
I want him to be in it, but that's not going to happen, I don't think.
Damn. Maybe he hears this show and he'll call you, maybe.
That would be great. It would be all my dreams come true. But I have met him a few times and I've spoken to him, and you're right, he's an amazing person. And we are lucky to have him in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's so great that there's people from every age, from all parts of the world. It's just that there's something that connects us.
Exactly. I just love that. And the one thing that I keep hearing from other people is that whenever they meet Adam fans, even if they've never met them before and they don't know them and they're from a different culture, a different country, it feels like family.
Yeah, that's so true. Yeah, we met so many amazing people while we were waiting for the show, and we had so much fun because we got new friends.
And this is family. We can't deny it.
It's true, isn't it? It's a kind of glamoury, is what he calls it, isn't it? It's a glamoury. And that kind of takes my breath away. He's connecting people all around the world. I mean, that to me is astonishing. I've not seen that before, but then I've never been a fan of anybody, so I don't know if that's normal. I don't think it is, though, from what I hear. Thank you so much, guys, for being on the Sound Bath.
Thank you
for inviting us.
You're very welcome. It's wonderful to talk to you, and I hope that maybe one day we can talk again.
Fans always travel to his concerts from all over the world, and the next young lady, Alba, a young medical doctor from Spain, chatted to me about her first live Adam Lambert experience.
My name is Alba. I am from Spain and I am 25 years old. I am a doctor. I am a very new medical doctor.
Oh, wow.
Very, very new. I finished a university last year.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's fantastic. So is this the first time you've seen Adam in Helsinki?
It was my first time, yeah. I am a pretty new fan. I mean, I only met him through Queen. It was my first chance to see him. I watched the YouTube videos.
Okay.
And I thought he was incredible. So I started following him, following his music, and I liked it. I started watching interviews, and I liked him. So here I am.
It's difficult not to like him because he's amazing, right?
Yeah, he's incredible.
So what did you think when you first saw him performing with Queen? I'm assuming you're a Queen fan.
Yeah, not a very serious fan of Queen, you know, I'm just a casual fan.
Right.
Well, I thought, it's funny, this story is funny. I was watching the EMAs because I knew Queen was going to perform. And when I saw him, I had no idea who he was. But when I saw him, I suddenly said, oh my God, that's Adam Lambert. He's the best one they could have gotten for Queen. I don't know how I knew him. That was a cool moment. Like, how did I know him? How did I know who he was? I have no idea. I only knew he was very good.
Wow. So did you see him on American Idol or anything? I mean, how did you know his name?
Maybe I saw a video. I don't know. I've been thinking a lot about it, but I don't know how I knew him. I seriously don't know.
That's amazing. I love it.
My father was looking at me like, who's that? And I had no idea. I only knew his name. I knew his face too because I recognized him, but I don't know.
Right. Maybe you saw him in a magazine or something?
Well, if I saw him in a magazine, it had to be on the internet because here in Spain, he's not known at all.
Really?
Well, in the UK, you guys get his CDs and everything. We don't even get the CDs here. We have to buy them through internet. We have to buy them online.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Yeah, he has fans, but no one knows him. No one mainstream knows him. Just people, you know, like me who watch videos on YouTube or something. Not normal people. He's not on the radio. He's not on the TV. He's not anywhere here.
Okay, so Helsinki was your very first Adam Lambert experience.
My very first one, yeah. And what an experience it was. He was perfect.
Yeah, he was on fire, I have to say. And it was fantastic because it was the last show of this little tour that he did. So can you explain what that was like to see him for the first time live? Were you close to the stage?
I was front row. I was...
Oh my God!
Yeah!
He must have knocked you sideways.
Yeah, I literally looked at him, the whole concert, I wasn't even moving. He looked at me a couple of times and I think he must have thought I was bored or something because I wasn't moving at all. I'm a loud girl at concerts, I like to sing, I like to dance, I like to shout. But I was completely blown away, I was just with my mouth hung open, I wasn't even singing.
He has that effect.
Yeah, it was like he had me on a spell or something, I don't know.
I remember it well, the first time I saw him, I was like that too, I stood rooted to the spot.
Yeah, And I was crying. I couldn't stop listening to him. I wanted to hear him. My boyfriend started singing, "What Do You Want From Me," for example, and I was like, shut up.
Really? Yes. Well, his voice is astonishing. I know that, you know, I mean, it is astonishing anyway, but it seems to get better and better and better every time I hear him.
Well, I wouldn't know it was the first time I saw him, but, well, it was incredible. He has an incredible voice. He has an... It was... And it's a very different live. I can't explain it because I don't know... I don't have the words in English, but, like, sweeter, I don't know. Like, someone on an online forum once said that he sings in 3D, in three dimensions. And I think that's pretty accurate.
Yes, there's been so many discussions about why his voice is so astonishing. But it is true that his voice is quite different live than it is when you hear it recorded, don't you think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah, I thought so. I mean, it sounds higher. It sounds like a bell, you know, like ringing.
Yes.
Here, yeah. I don't know how to explain it, sorry. But yeah, I mean, from sound check, I put my ear on the door,
right.
And I was like, he sounds so different. Even from outside the arena,
right.
I thought that he sounded different. I didn't get perfect sound because when you are in front rows, the sound is a little distorted sometimes.
That's true.
So next time, because there's going to be a next time,
of course.
I'm going to try to maybe sit down or stand a little farther from the stage to hear better.
The problem with that is that once you have experienced Adam's energy like that, so close...
I know.
You will not be able to stand further away.
I'm saying this now, but maybe when the opportunity to see him again comes, maybe I will aim for front row again. When he came to the stage and he started looking at people, because he looks at people's eyes, when he first looked at me, it was like, ooh, it was like a shock, you know? Like an electric shock, like, oh, she's looking at me. And at first it was I was a little intimidated, like a little taken aback, like, oh, why is he looking at me? Why is he singing at me? But after a while I started like wishing he would look at me more often. Come on, look at me, I'm here. Look at me and sing to me. Yeah. I've never felt that way. I've seen many people I like, many artists I like, and I've never felt that way before.
He puts us in a spell, you're right. But yes, once you've had that experience, it's impossible not to want it again.
I understand it now.
Yes, because I'm sure you must have read about it or heard people talk about the fact that he's got this power thing going on stage.
Yeah, and he does.
It's a huge stage presence, but there's something more than that. Right.
Yeah, it's not just his voice, it's not just how he looks or how he talks, it's something he has, some kind of light, I don't know how to explain it. He's magnetic.
That's a very good word. Do you think he knows it?
I don't know, I don't think he does, because reading his interviews or, I don't know, watching his interviews, I don't think he does.
It's something that all good performers strive for, all performers who want to affect an audience. But very few actually ever achieve it. The fact that he not only achieves it, but he seems to be a master at it, kind of blows my mind, I have to say.
Yeah, and it's effortless for him, I think. Like, he doesn't even try. He doesn't go on a stage and think, I'm going to put them on in a spell. I don't think he thinks that before going on a stage. He just does it.
Maybe, I don't know. I don't know. I can't say from his point of view. I can only speak from my own point of view as a performer.
Mm-hmm.
We do think about it and we work very hard to achieve that.
Maybe, I don't know. I mean, I don't perform, so...
Yeah.
I'm sure he's very prepared. He's had a lot of preparation, so...
No, but I like the fact that you picked up on the fact that it's effortless for him. Because that's the artistry, you know? No matter how much you work... If you are able to do it so effortlessly and it looks like you're not doing it at all,
yeah,
then you're a master at what you've been working towards.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's actually really difficult to do what he's doing.
I don't know, because I have never performed, so I'm sure it is, because I haven't seen it before.
Yeah, there's very few people who can do that, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this was the first time that you flew somewhere specifically to see Adam.
Yeah, it sounds so crazy. My mother thought I was a nutcase. I mean,
and
my boyfriend thought that I was crazy too. He didn't want to come at first. He was like, no, we're not going anywhere.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, the first time I saw him, I flew to New Orleans to to see him from London. Whoa. Yeah, crazy. So I think people do that a lot. So my question is this, would you be flying again wherever he's performing? Would you go?
I would. If I had, you know, the money, if the timing was right, I totally would.
I mean, it's interesting because I think he has also succeeded in building this huge global family.
Yeah, he has very loyal fans. Yes. Very, very loyal fans, yeah.
Yeah, and that to me is amazing because I met quite a few of them and it was just so fantastic to meet all these people. And everywhere I go, I meet people from all over the world that's come together and they've become friends because of
it. Yeah, it was the first time I met other fans and it was so comfortable. I mean, it wasn't awkward, it wasn't, I don't know, it was like I knew them already.
It really feels like family, right?
Yeah, a sense of closeness.
And you talked about the fact that you also follow other artists. Mm-hmm. So presumably you've met other artists' fans as well.
Yeah.
Do they have the same, does it feel the same?
No, not at all. People seem to be more casual when it comes to other artists. They don't follow them as strongly.
That to me is the thing that fascinates me. And that's partly one of the reasons why I've started interviewing some of his fans. Because I find this passionate, loyal following to him, but also seemingly to each other.
Mm-hmm.
They make friends and they stay friends. And I find that quite astonishing. It's unusual, right?
Yeah, it's very unusual. That's another thing I have never seen before. But I think it's not just his talent, not just his art. It's himself. He's a very interesting person. When he tweets, when he gives an interview, he's interesting. He has interesting opinions. He has interesting points of view. So I think it's also that part of himself.
I agree with you. I think he has something to say for himself. And mm-hmm. he's intelligent and able yeah. to express himself very eloquently. Yeah.
And he surprises me sometimes. Like yesterday, I think it was, when he tweeted, Happy Easter. I don't know, he surprises me knowing those things, like the origins of Easter. And he's very, very eloquent when he speaks, when he explains himself. He knows how to drive his point across.
Exactly, and I think that's quite unusual too.
Yeah, especially mainstream artists.
You met him at the airport. What was that like?
Embarrassing.
Why?
Because I was shaking so hard. I mean, I was so starstruck. My hands were... And I was like, oh my god, I'm sorry, I'm so nervous. Oh my god, I'm sorry, because I couldn't make my phone work to take the picture. It was embarrassing, a little bit, yeah. He was very patient with me.
Did he recognize you from the show?
I don't think so.
He's got an amazing memory. He recognizes a lot of his fans.
I don't think, well, maybe he did, but he didn't say.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there are stories people say that, oh, he knew me, he knew my face, he knew my name, or he remembered what we had talked before. Because he's very different, even his speaking voice surprised me a lot.
In what
because
way?
You don't hear the same voice when you listen to recorded interviews or videos. You don't get the same sound. I mean, I was like, oh, that voice. I even thought, oh, I didn't think it wasn't him, obviously, but it finally surprised me a lot. Oh, it sounds so different.
Yeah. Is it also higher than you imagined?
Yeah, his speaking voice is also higher, yeah. And softer, I don't know, more gentle, more beautiful, too. It sounds more beautiful in person, I think.
Okay, so if you were to meet him again, or even if not, is there a message you would like to give him?
I would like to say how much I enjoy his music, that I admire him a lot as a person too, but I think he has the best voice I've ever seen, and I've seen a lot of people already. And I would also say that he's made my life more interesting.
In what way?
I don't even remember what I did with my time before Adam.
I'm laughing because we all feel the same way.
What did I do before? For fun, you know? He sneaks into your life little by little and then he stays there and you can never get rid of him. Not that I would want to get rid of him, of course.
Exactly. This is actually the other question I was going to ask you, is how else does he impact on your life?
he's a good role model. He doesn't think so. I don't think he realized that he's really such a good role model, but he is. The way he behaves when something around him goes wrong or when someone puts him something nasty, the way he reacts, it's an example.
I agree with you. I don't know if he knows that he's doing that, but he always behaves with such dignity and sophistication.
Yeah.
And I adore him for that because he never seems to flap. I'm sure he does because he's human, but he never seems to let the situation run away with him somehow.
I agree. He's always in control of the situation, I think. He always knows how to behave, how to react to something. I'm sure he bends when he's in private, but in public, he knows exactly what to say, how to do things, how to behave. It's really very amazing to see, because it's a little bit difficult to always know what to say and what to do in a situation. And he does it. I don't think I've ever seen him making mistakes in interviews.
And the thing about it is that I think if something does seem to want to go wrong, he turns it around. You know, even in performance, I've watched him do performance where things do go wrong and he turns it around. He makes it work.
I completely agree with you. It's amazing to see. Answering your question before, I think you asked how did he impact on my life?
Yes.
I've learned a lot since I became a fan. I've learned not only English. I've learned a lot about social things, like LGBT things and things. I already was very active before on Twitter with LGBT stuff. And now even more so.
Right.
And some things I didn't pay attention before, social things, and now I do. You know, and I think that's pretty important, that he makes people think.
Oh, undoubtedly. And I've heard other people say this too, that he's opened up their consciousness in a way and sort of woken them up. What you said just now is interesting. Did you say you learned English? You mean you couldn't speak English before?
No, I knew English before, but I've gotten better at it.
Oh, good. I was going to say, wow, that's amazing.
He makes us do new things.
Yes.
All the time. He's also a great showman.
Yes.
The way he performs, his stage presence is big. I've never seen someone who seemed so big on a stage before me. He seemed huge.
That's true, isn't it? But then when you met him up close, he's really tall as well, isn't he?
He's tall. He's really, really tall. He had to bend a lot to take the thing with me.
I'm so happy you met him.
I'm happy and then I'm embarrassed too.
Oh, you shouldn't be.
I only hope I didn't bother him. He was lining up to get a sandwich. And I was like, okay, he's on the line. If I don't do this now, I don't think I'll ever do it. So
good for you. No, good for you. I'm so pleased that you took this time to talk to me. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. I love your blog.
Oh, thank you.
I really do, yeah.
Oh, I really
appreciate it. I read your Queen article. I love that. You went to the fish shows.
I did.
Oh my God.
I was greedy. But you know, they were all very different from each other. And that's the thing with Adam. If you see him do that one show again, 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 and you go every single night, you'll see a different show. The set list remains the same. Everything remains the same. But Adam gives a different show every single night. So yes, the three nights with Queen was amazing and different from each other.
I wish I had gone. I couldn't go, but I wish I had gone. I think they might do it again because it was very successful. It was very special for them, I think.
Absolutely.
But I think they will do it again. And I will be there too.
Great. Yes. Well, it was lovely to talk to you. Thank you ever so much for coming on to the sound bar.
Thank you for wanting to interview me.
This is what I do to try and help Adam. It's all I can do. So I love it when other people want to participate in helping to promote him with me.
And hopefully you and I will meet in person someday.
That would be fantastic. Thank you. Ciao. Bye.
Most of Adam's fans are known to me only by their Twitter and online names. So let me introduce finally Jean Genie, as she's known on Twitter, from London. Another fan for whom Helsinki was a first. She talked to me about her thoughts on Adam.
So welcome to the sound bath, Jean Genie. It's lovely to have you here. And it was fantastic to share this amazing experience with you in Helsinki, because of course we went together and we had this amazing experience there. But as I understand it, this was the first time that you've actually seen Adam doing a show, one of his shows, live. I know you saw the Queen ones and stuff, but this is the first time you actually saw him
live doing one of his shows properly.
Yeah. And the first time seeing an audience that were there solely for him in regards. So I was really interested in what the audience's reactions were to him, you know, surrounding me, because we managed to get, as you know, right up near the front, about 10 people back rows, so we had a very good view. But the audience's reaction to him was absolutely amazing, and watching people around me, how they were engaged. And just like, there was that adoration there, but there was also this complete awe for what he was doing, like unbelievable kind of, you know, not quite believing what they saw in a way, or heard, you know. So that reaction was almost as equally as powerful, I think, you know. But it was a reaction to Adam. So, but the first thing, of course, I noticed is when he came on stage, was it just that whole, he's just a magnet, really. You know, this kind of energy coming from like some sort of magnetic field. It's all like, it's how I can explain it, best explain it. And it's so powerful, and to the point where you're really not engaged with anybody else, watching anybody else on stage, or, you know, it's all attention's on him, really. And, you know, this show was really simple. And I know, I didn't see Glam Nation, and I know that he had a lot more trim. There were sort of trimmings and, you know, the props and a bit more of a set or whatever. And I've seen the DVD. But this one was much, much more simplified. The lighting was great. But, you know, he doesn't need all those kind of trimmings and sets, right? I mean, that's, you know, and I kind of go, in my mind, a kind of real strong performer, entertainer, doesn't need that and can just work individually what they've got, you know, what God has given them, so to speak. And, you know, that became relevant. I didn't miss or need, you know, props and sets or big fancy sort of, you know, Lady Gaga style. Yeah?
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. And of course his voice, you know, there's no denying it sounds, I mean, it's amazing, whatever, but just live, the power is just really mind-blowing. So I had a great time, and as you know, it went so quick, and I just could have easily, I think each time, if you know, I could easily have seen it again, and we wish we'd gone to St. Petersburg or whatever, and we will see him again, but he met every expectation, so yeah, it was just fantastic, and it was an electrifying, the whole atmosphere. Yeah, I think things are slowly, even, you know, it's been a slow progress for him in some ways, but in other ways, it's still growing. I can feel the momentum growing. It's not going, nobody's going anywhere. Mm. People, once they become fans, that's it.
I agree. I absolutely agree with you. Definitely.
Yeah. And
you get hooked by him.
Yeah. He's not a quick fix. And I think that's going to be to his advantage in a kind of strategic sense. Mm. So I have no fears about his career or whatever. I think, you know, as he's a strong live performer. And at the end of the day, he's got that to fall back on, even if the big, you know, the radio hits don't necessarily come. But I feel he's, yeah, going in the right direction, and the Finnish audience, you know, kind of proved that. I mean, there was 11,000
people come to see.
It was huge. Mm. I don't know what the numbers were at Glam Nation with different venues. I know it varied.
But it did vary, but it was. I mean, he did have quite good numbers, but it wasn't an arena like this.
No. And it's just powerful. Because I've seen him at Heaven, right? And he just did 5 tracks. And as I say, not everyone there was there for him. And so I've seen him right up close do that. And he, at that level, he entertains, but he can also fill the arena. Mm. Just this one man that can fill this arena.
It's amazing, right?
It is amazing.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, even Mick Jagger had his Rolling Stones band, you know. There's very few artists that could fill a whole arena like him. Even David Bowie had problems.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, he talked about his whole Phil Collins years, you know, being the Glass Spider tour and that. You know, the Sirius Moonlight as not being the ones he felt the most comfortable in, doing this huge big, it's a very 80s thing, wasn't it, doing this huge big auditorium, and he didn't feel, and he was good, he carried it up well. Actually, the Glass Spider tour, I think, you know, didn't work so well for him, even Bowie, but, you know, I could see Adam filling those kind of stages, because that's the kind of performer he is, so he can do both.
Yeah,
he's
definitely.
He's so versatile, he's that kind of performer, he can adapt, he's that chameleon, and that's what, you know, I love about him. But I was thinking about the tour, the Helsinki gig, this trespassing tour, or it's the non-tour tour, whatever it's called. There's not one Duff song.
Hmm.
I mean, same as the album, right? I mean, we all have our favourites, but I was listening to it a lot the other day when I was doing my DIY. There's not one Duff song. I mean, there's not one weak song.
Yeah, that's true.
And so creatively, the songs he's coming up with, the written material, it's good. I mean, it's growing, you know, and...
And he'll get better as he's doing it more and more.
I agree. He'll get better. Yeah. He'll find his own
way through it as well, you know, not just relying on co-writers and whatever. Yeah. But the same with your entertainment. There's not one track that I think is weak.
That's true. I agree with you. Mm. Absolutely. Mm. And that's what was amazing to me with For Your Entertainment, and even more astonishing on Trespassing Again, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure it'll happen like that always with Adam's albums, because he seems to want to also make music that he likes to listen to. So he doesn't want to listen to duff music, I suppose.
But he's got, I mean, not only has he got a good ear for, you know, how his vocals himself, how he sings, whatever, he has a good ear for what works, you know, on a track or whatever, what works.
Yeah. I was going to say to you, if you could give him a message,
gosh,
what would you say?
Just keep doing what you're doing, Adam. I mean, it's all perfect, you know, it's growing, and don't change. I know you won't anyway. I know you won't anyway. But, you know, that's what he's loved for, and doing his own thing. He's finding his own path. And that seems cliche, but yeah, apart from that, you know, I love you. We all love you.
Great. Well, thank you ever so much. That's fantastic. And I hope you'll come back to the Sound Bath at some point and talk to us again.
I'd love to. Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye.
In London in 2016, Adam's voice again seems to have grown even more in beauty, and perhaps singing the challenging Queen repertoire had something to do with it. I love this song, Running, from his second album, Trespassing, which he sang in London. Christine Smith likes it too and suggested it, and it was brought to us by Kiss and Tell. And if you continue to watch the video, you'll also hear Chokehold and Sleepwalker, another two of my favourites. Continue to listen to the wonderful songs he leaves in his wake as his bright star continues to climb higher and higher. There will be many to choose from because Adam never stops working. Thank you for listening to The Sound Bath. Join us again next time when we'll have more stimulating glimpses into the worlds of music and words.